Mr. Thornbody drove me home and picked me up about an hour later. He was dressed in a pair of shorts and a white shirt. I've never seen him dress so casually before, though. I felt kind of overdressed in my suit, but it was too late to change, and Mom had insisted. Hi, Mr. Thornbody. I thought we were going to the concert.
We are, but in my haste of going to the hospital last night, I didn't have time to wash any clean clothes.
We got there around 7. Plenty of time before, but there was already a crowd. Mr. Thornbody showed the backstage passes to the parking attendant, and he directed us to show it to someone near the back of the lot. From there, we were directed to behind the theater and given a special spot. Once we got out, we got met at the car by someone I didn't recognize.
Dipper Draper? You're the one I was sent out here to get?
I think so. I have the backstage passes. Here.
Yep, that's his signature, all right. Wow, you're the last one I'd expect to see here. I'm a big fan of yours.
Really? Wow, I thought you worked for Justin Bieber, though.
I do, but doesn't mean Justin's stuff is the only thing I listen to. Come on, I'll take you to him.
We followed him into the backstage area. They were still doing sound checks. I had been through enough of them to know what was going on and not to get in the way. Mr. Thornbody, though, looked completely lost. I guess he'd never done anything like this before. The guy who met us took us straight to the dressing room area and knocked on a door.
Justin, they're here, sir.
Dipper, Sam, you made it.
Wow! You're Justin Bieber!
Just call me Justin, okay? Come on in.
We came in and he showed us to a couple of seats. He already had his stage makeup on. I knew what that stuff was like, so although it made him look kind of weird, I didn't say anything.
I'm really glad you two could make it. Sam told me about Bobby Dipper. How's he holding up?
He was really lucky. He's feeling a lot better. I'm sorry he couldn't come, but they wanted to keep him there while they made sure that he was going to be okay.
It was more important that you got here, Dipper. I wanted to talk to you.
Yeah, I kind of thought something was up when both Bobby and Mr. Thornbody absolutely insisted that I be here. They didn't say why, though.
Bobby told me yesterday that you met up with an agent by the name of Jason Marley. Dipper, you have got to listen. If you sign with him, you are going to regret it.
I am? But he said he represented a lot of big names, like Whitney Austin and White Lightning and John Campbell.
Dipper, I'm curious. Do you know anything that all three of those have in common?
You mean besides Jason? No. Justin walked over to a nearby cabinet and pulled out what looked like a bunch of small newspaper article clippings. He brought them over to me.
Dipper, every one of them has succumbed to a drug problem.
I leafed through them. Each showed a different celebrity being arrested, most for either cocaine or heroin. The name of Jason Marley was highlighted on each one. But the last one shocked me. It showed Justin Bieber checking himself into a drug clinic. I had no idea.
I'm not saying Jason was responsible for the problems directly, but he didn't do much to stop it from happening either.
I suddenly flashed back to my talk with him.
I won't tell a soul.
That's what he said after he set the liquor bottle down in front of both Bobby and I. Wow, but he said he would make me famous. I would have lots of money and everything.
Yeah, he's made those comments before. The only fame that came out of any of them was the fact that every arrest was televised. And as for the money, Dipper, he told me the same story he probably told you. That he could get you anything you wanted, and everything you did would be up to you. Well, he wasn't long on his word with me. Within a week, he had me under a financial advisor who barely ever let me see my money without an excuse.
So you never really saw it then?
Nope. And the travel he promised me? I had to go wherever he wanted to go. Because he wanted to get the biggest money-making gigs he could get. I very seldom got to pick my own concert locations, and whenever I did, he was right there with his greedy paws out to collect the money from me.
Wow. But you at least got to see your family whenever you wanted, didn't you?
That, Dipper, is one of the hardest parts of it. You're lucky, Dipper. You have a family that cares about you greatly. Not to mention that you also work with your uncles as part of the Beach Bears. Dipper, I didn't exactly have the best life at home. My father was a lazy drunk, and my mom, well, let's just say she'd benefit from visiting Sam here.
Wow. But I thought you, of all people, you'd have the best of everything. I guess I was wrong, huh?
You have the better life, Dipper. Uncles to watch over you, a father or mother that care about you, a friend who'll do anything for you.
Yeah, anything. I really have it good, don't I?
You sure do. I'd love to have it as carefree and easy as you, Dipper.
You mean you're still working with Mr. Marley?
Good Lord, no. I caught on to his scheme and managed to find a way out of my contract.
Really? How?
You know my security guard? The snow leopard that met you two when you got here?
Yeah, he said he was a fan of mine.
He also used to be a lawyer.
He was a lawyer? Before he worked for you? Why did he quit?
It's a long story, Dipper. Back when I started getting suspicious of Mr. Marley's actions, I started asking to see my contract. Every time I did, he managed to change the subject. So, one day, during one of the very few times I got to go back home to Austin, I hired a lawyer to help me. That was Reggie. He did some investigating and discovered a few things that Mr. Marley had been hiding, including having changed the wording of the contract, so anyone that saw it would know that he was supposed to get a ridiculous portion of all the money. What Mr. Marley didn't count on was Reggie finding the original contract I signed. When that weasel realized we had him pinned, and that I could take legal action against him, he agreed to void our contract and he let me go. Shortly after that, when I got signed to the agent I'm with now, I found out that Reggie had quit his job as a lawyer because he took an interest in my situation, and I made him my security guard. Being only 16 at the time, I needed someone I knew I could trust to keep it from happening again.
Wow. You got hooked on drugs at only 16?
Earlier than that, I'm afraid.
That's awful, and... Wait!
I looked over at Mr. Thornbody.
You mean that's the kind of therapy you've been doing with Justin?
That's right, Dipper. It happens a lot more often than you'd think, and it only really takes once to start a problem that, if you don't get control of it, can wreck your life.
I looked from Mr. Thornbody to Justin and back again.
So that's why you're out of town so often.
Exactly. My job makes me go many places, and Austin, Texas is just one of them.
Dipper, think carefully about the decisions you make. If you're not careful, you can end up having a lot worse problems than you realize.
Oh, don't worry about that, Justin. I've made some stupid decisions in my life for sure. But after what you just told me, this isn't going to be one of them.
Good.
5 minutes, Justin.
Thank you, Reggie. Go with Reggie. He'll get you to your seat. I need to finish preparing. Oh, and Dipper, consider yourself lucky you have a friend that was concerned enough to try and stop you before these things happened. I'd have loved to have had someone like Bobby to stop me from making the mistakes I did.
Yeah, right. Thanks, Justin. I'll remember that. Don't worry, I'll make sure that Mr. Marley doesn't bother me anymore.
Enjoy the rest of the concert, you two.
We will. Thank you, Justin.
As Reggie led us to our seats, I had to ask.
Reggie, is it okay if I call you that? Justin said you helped him get away from Mr. Marley. I just find it odd that he just happens to be in town at the same time as Justin is. Do you know anything about that?
I'm sure he's trying to get Justin to sign with him again. Just in the last week alone, he called Justin twice.
Yeah, and he somehow found out where I live, too. Wow, he's really aggressive, isn't he?
Jason Marley's a sneaky man, Dipper. He tries to take control of every singer he gets.
Well, that's what Mr. Marley said about Les.
Dipper, you're safe where you are. You may not have everything you want, but I'd rather be safe than rich.
Well, I think you're wrong there.
Oh? How so?
You can't always get what you want, but if you try sometimes, well, you might find you get what you need.
Very good choice of words, Dipper. That's very smart.
Reggie showed us to our reserved seats at the front of the stage. There was already a huge, loud crowd. Some people actually recognized me as we sat down. Reggie then left us quickly and headed backstage. The lights went down and we were put in darkness. The crowd noise got louder.
Ladies and gentlemen, Justin Bieber!
You're gonna lose that girl. You're gonna lose that girl. If you don't take her out tonight, she's gonna change her
she's
mind.
Gonna change her mind.
And I'll take her out tonight and I'll treat her,
I'll
kind.
Treat her.
You're gonna lose that girl.
Yes, you're gonna
treat her right, my friend. You're gonna find her.
girl.